Kia ora, Year 12. Here's another really old excellence question, this time from the 2011 paper. So this is about the total fluid force on the vertical face of an object. And in this case, we're talking about the wall of a dam at one end of a reservoir. It's got quite a simple shape. It's in the shape of an isosceles trapezium, and this is what it looks like here. What we have to work out is the total fluid force on the dam when the reservoir is full. So this is not going to be a differential equation problem. We haven't got something leaking or changing. We just have to use this formula here to work out the fluid force on the object in tons. So we need to go through all of these bits down here really carefully. Y is going to be the depth below the surface in meters, and that's going to be my variable. And W, depending on y, so W is a function of y, is the width of the object at depth y below the surface in meters. A is the depth of the top of the object below the surface in meters. So we know that when we're at the top of the object, it's full. So A is going to be 0. And B is the depth at the bottom of the object below the surface in meters. So B is going to be 40. Now the tricky bit, and it's not really that tricky if you see what's going on, is to work out the width of the object at depth y below the surface in meters. And we need to come up with a function for that. So let's just do some back of the envelope stuff. When we are 0 below, then the width is 200. When we are 40 below, the width is 120. And we can see that that is dropping in a linear manner. So the equation that we're going to get for W of Y is just going to be a linear equation. And it's going to be 200 minus, well, what's happened here? We've gone down 80, so we've dropped by 80. It's the depth has gone down by 40. So it's going to be 200 minus 2y. And that's all we need to do to solve the problem. So by far the hardest part in this question is doing that setup that we've just done. Now we're going to chuck all of that into the formula and see what we come up with. So F will go from 40 to 0, and then it's y times 200 minus 2y dy. Probably one of the easiest integration calculations that you have to do in a level 3 integration paper. So let's see what we get. Well, we've got 100 times 40 squared minus 2/3 40 cubed. Right, what do I have here? 1600, doing this without a calculator. This minus 2/3 of 64,000. Which at this point you can reach for your calculator, 160,000. Sorry, I paused the video while I worked that out. So it's 160,000 minus 42,666.6 recurring, which gives us 117,333, and I need units for this. So I think the unit will be tons. Let's see if it tells us. Yep. It is. Okay, so there we go. So that's that question. It looks really weird and it takes a bit of thinking about. So I think it's one where it's probably worth doing it, going through it, and then come back to it in a few days and make sure that you can do it yourself. You might want to change the numbers around the second time and make up a different shape or different dimensions for the isosceles trapezium. Thanks for watching.